Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. This is Karuna teaching the course Microprocessors and Microcontrollers. In this video, we are concentrating on memory segmentation. Processor is having 20 address lines. Memory capacity can be determined with the help of these 20 address lines. That means 2 power 20 is 1 MB megabyte locations. 1 megabyte locations are required to store the data or addresses for this 8086 microprocessor. So, coming to this memory, physical memory. Memory is divided into 4 segments: data segment, code segment, stack segment, extra segment. Each segment capacity is 64 kilobyte. Okay, to fulfill 1 megabyte memory, entire memory divided into 16 segments. That means 4 data segments, 4 code segments, 4 stack segments, 4 extra segments. Okay, so in this figure shows only 1 segment. Let us see here. 20 bit address lines, 20 binary bits can be represented in terms of hexa with 5 digits, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 digits. Okay, so this is the starting address of 1 MB memory, and this is the ending address of the entire memory. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 Fs. Okay, 5 into 4, 20 bits. Let us see segments individually. Let us consider data segment. This is the starting address of the data segment, 20000, and ending address of this data segment, 2FFFF. Okay, likewise, code segment starting address, ending address, stack segment starting address, ending address, extra segment starting address and ending address. Each segment capacity must be 64 KB. Okay, so the starting address of the data segment, that is bottom of this, is ending address of the data segment is the top of the data segment. Okay, so this starting address also known as base address of that particular segment. Likewise, these 4 segments positioned in memory at any given time. Okay, these 4 64 KB segments might be positioned within 1 megabyte of memory. Okay, or we can say 4 segments can be separated like this. Okay, for small programs which do not need all 64 kilobytes in each segment, they can overlap. Okay, this is about physical memory required for this 8086 microprocessor. Coming to the processor, processor having 4 segment registers available in bus interfacing unit. 4 segment registers are available in the processor. Those are stack segment register, data segment register, extra segment register, code segment register. Each segment register is used to store the upper 16 bits of the starting address. For example, here code segment starting address is 348A0. Okay, so upper 16 bits 348A, 4 4s are 16, 348A. Upper 16 bits are stored in code segment register. That means base address of the code segment. Okay, this indicates base address of the code segment. In this memory, here 64 KB segment can be located at anywhere within the 1 megabyte address space. But segment will always start at an address with zeros in the lowest 4 bits. See, all segments starting addresses consist 0 in the lowest nibble. Okay, data segment, extra segment are used to store the data. Code segment can be used to store the code. Stack segment can be used to store data or addresses. So this is about segments in the memory, and these are the registers related to this segment present in processor. Okay, each segment register is used to hold the upper 16 bits of the starting address for each of the segment. Now let us see how the physical address of the data or instruction code can be calculated. Let us take this is the code segment. Okay, so here the required instruction byte is available at 38AB4H. Code segment starting address is 34880, ending address 4489F. Okay, so let us see how to calculate physical address of this instruction byte with the help of instruction pointer and code segment register contents. Okay, so code segment used to store the starting address of the code segment, that is 348A. Okay, so instruction pointer is used to hold the address of the next instruction, that is 4214. Okay, CS and IP are the 16 bit code segment register used to store the starting address of the code segment, that is 348A. Code segment is a 16 bit register, stores 16 bits only. Instruction point stores the address of the next instruction. This is also 16 bit register. It stores 4214. Okay, so hence actual physical address can be produced by adding offset and base address of the code segment. Okay, so here to generate physical address, here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 digits are used to represent 20 bit address. Okay, so but our register capacity is 16 bits only, that's what it stores only upper bits of the starting address stored in CS register. Okay, so last digit inserted by the hardwired circuit. Okay, so let us see how this 0 will be inserted, because every base address of the segment must consist 0 at lowest nibble position. Okay, so that's what hardwired circuit is used to insert 0. Okay, in LSB bit position. Okay, see, let us see how that 0 will be inserted. Okay, so for example, 348A is the starting address of the code segment. Perform left shift operation by 4 times, because to shift 1 digit means 4 bits are to be shifted left. Okay, so 00111, 3 will be shifted to left, 4 will be shifted to left, and 8 will be shifted to left, A will be shifted to left, and automatically zeros will be inserted in least significant positions. Okay, now this is the shifted version of the base address stored in CS. Now offset address, instruction pointer contains the offset address that will be added to the shifted version of the CS content, that to generate physical address of the required code byte. Okay, if you perform addition operation, then 4 will you get 4. If you add these 4 bits, you will get A8 3. Okay, so this is how physical address will be generated. Okay, so the this is the physical address of the required code byte from the code segment. Okay, likewise instruction pointer used to point the instruction code byte in code segment. Okay, similarly in case of data segment, SI register content is used to point the data available in the data segment register. To point the data in extra segment, DA register content is used. Likewise, base pointer also used in case of DS or ES. Instruction pointer is used to point the instruction code available in the code segment. base register. I told you AX, BX, CX, DX. BX is used to store the offset address. That is used to point the data available in the data segment or extra segment. Okay. Now stack pointer. It is also used to point the data or addresses available in the stack segment, or we can say stack pointer is used to hold the top of the stack. Okay. Likewise, physical address of the instruction code can be calculated with the help of CS and IP, and also physical address of the data can be calculated with the help of SI, DS, DS and DA, ES and so on. Okay. Thank you. We will meet in next video.